Dr. Singhvi, you would have seen the poll of polls. You would have seen various agency-wise polls, which project a huge win for the BJP alliance in Haryana and in Maharashtra. Your first reactions to what you're seeing, sir?
I haven't actually seen the figures, but I've heard of them. And subject to my usual caveat about how polls can be wrong and misleading, I don't want to get into that. I think we have to just now accept whatever is the verdict. But let me tell you two or three things. I think this excessively gung-ho attitude of the ruling parties in these places may well be misplaced. I can't be sure about the figures. In Maharashtra, for example, people are forgetting that for 4.5 out of the 5 years, the so-called allies who are now fighting together as the ruling dispensation, the Shiv Sena was the biggest critic of the government and possibly ahead of every opposition party, yep, in viciously criticizing the government.
Yes.
So a marriage of convenience 3 months before elections, I think, is underestimating the electorate's astuteness or the electorate's maturity. People see through this kind of a charade. Number two, as against that, you have a very, very old, well-known, tested coalition of the Congress and the NCP. They've not only ruled for more than 10 years, but they've had a cohesiveness and a coordination which is far, far ahead of the BJP Shiv Sena. I think it prevents vote division. It has prevented bickering. There is subdued resistance and anger within the alliance at the ruling level. Each candidate is snapping at the other's heels. So I don't think that this easy, overwhelming victory is so easily predictable.
No, but sir, if you look
thirdly, I think but what Dr. really Singhvi, matters on the ground.
Right, but Dr. Singhvi, let me ask you this. You know, you can disagree with a poll, you can disagree with two polls, but just an average of everything indicates that of 288 seats in Maharashtra, the Shiv Sena and the BJP are up to 211. Now, you can say that this is wrong, you know, it'll be lower. See, fair enough. But what the sense is that the margin of victory, and this is what a lot of people would say, that where is the opposition? Even if it's not this, it's less than this. The margin of the victory means that effectively we don't have an opposition in either of these states, because even in Haryana, the numbers are very different.
I concede that if these polls are right, then assuming that they are 33% less than what they predict, even then the majority would be the same.
Yes.
I entirely concede. Well, what does one do on the evening of a program with polls?
No, that's okay.
They are neither the actual results.
I take your point.
They are speculation.
Right.
You have to deal with reasons. No. One minute. You have to deal with reasons which suggest that these may be exaggerated results. And remember, in India, there is no homogeneity of the kind expected to validate exit polls even. Although exit polls are more accurate than opinion polls, exit polls in India do not display the same degree of homogeneity.
No, they don't. And so that's
so
a,
now
that's
you have
a,
to look at reasons why this may be wrong. Although I concede that even if they are wrong and if I'm right for the reasons, even then the majority may be that.
Okay.
But I'm just saying this one-sided sweep for the reasons I'm saying, and just 5 seconds, 10 seconds, the ground reality of unemployment, of the economic figures, is the third factor which people are underestimating. It's all very well for Mr. Modi and Mr. Fadnavis to constantly beat the drum of 370 and, you know, uniform civil code laenge and Ayodhya hone wala and all this. But people ultimately ask hard answers to hard questions.
No, but is it not your worry, Dr. Singhvi? Is it not your worry, Dr. Singhvi? And again, with the usual caveat and your caveat that what you mentioned, that even if this is 33% off, that in this country, for whatever the reasons are, this national security discourse, the strident nationalism, whether it's associated with Ayodhya or with Kashmir or with NRC, the way it's been spun and the way that it's being believed is what people want to hear. And it's what people are willing to vote on. So therefore, the very real issues that the Congress talks about, unemployment, agrarian distress, farmer suicides, why is it then that there is no connect between that reality, it's a statistical reality, and people casting their vote?
Two things. One, to an extent you are right, no doubt, because people do move on emotions. But two, that factor is significantly less in a state election than in the recently concluded national elections. That's a thing which you are forgetting. Thirdly, there is a law of diminishing returns about emotive issues. Our Prime Minister is a master orator and he knows how to spin these. But don't you find that his speeches spinning these same things again and again do have a feeling and an appearance of law of diminishing returns? At the end, the person goes out and asks, what did he say about...
We don't know. I mean, it's quite possible
IMF revised rate. I'm prepared to bet you this, that it'll be a lesser factor than the national elections, although I can't deny it'll be a factor.
Okay. Fair enough, Dr. Singhvi. One final question, if I can, to you. The issue of leadership, Sonia Gandhi has not campaigned extensively, if at all, either in Maharashtra or in Haryana. Rahul Gandhi has campaigned a lot. But in terms of your national leadership, if people are voting still for the image of Narendra Modi or for Narendra Modi, who is the opposition, who is the Congress leader that people can look up to in a country where, you know, this charisma of a leader is something which carries a lot of weight?
While conceding that we have had difficult times from April till recently, both pre-election and post-election, because of the, change of mind of Rahul Gandhi, there's no doubt that we have been in difficulty. Again, I think that this is an old stereotype question about the Congress. We have not, when we were in power ourselves, when Sonia Gandhi, Manmohan Singh, Rahul Gandhi belonged to a party which was in power, we never went in for state elections with a declared CM candidate, except in one or two rare exceptions.
Right.
And exceptions prove the rule.
Right.
So I don't think, and secondly, in the state level, I think again it is being overstated. Yes, for a ruling party, Modi's image and persona is very, very important. But people do relate ultimately to the Fadnavises or to the Ashok Chavans, the Prithviraj Chavans, the local leader in Sindhugarh,
okay,
the local leader in Vidarbha.
Okay.
So, you know, there is again a difference of degree, although I must concede that their mascot remains Modi. There's no doubt about it.
Okay. Well, Dr. But Abhishek Manu Singhvi, I take your point.
I doubt the same resonance as the national level.
Fair enough. And that's something we need to debate, whether Modi carries the same weight in the mind of the voter, or is it regional issues which also play a more significant role than perhaps at the national level. Thanks very much, sir, for joining us.